So as we saw, up to 3NF or BCNF is practical, but it may still have certain problems. For example, in the database course example that we saw, if a teacher teaches the course on database, the books must be common to all the teachers. Now, to handle such anomalies and to go to higher normal forms, we will require the concept of what is called a multi-valued dependency. So a multi-valued dependency, it is mostly written as MVD instead of a functional dependency, which is sometimes written as FD. So it's a multi-valued dependency, MVD. It is defined in the following way. So suppose Y depends, multi-value depends on X. So this is the symbol. First of all, note the symbol. This is a different from the FD symbol because there are two arrows. And now this holds for all value or for a relation schema R. This holds if for all legal instances of R. Now if there is a pair of tuples T1 and T2 such that the following happens. Now suppose these are the conditions. So suppose T1 dot x is equal to T2 dot x. Then there are two more other tuples such that T3 dot x is equal to T4 dot x, and those are then equal to T1 dot x, which means these are also equal to T2 dot x. So all these four tuples have the same x part, and if T3 dot y is equal to T1 dot y and T3 dot r minus y minus x. So, r minus y minus x is essentially all the attributes that are in the relation r but not in y and not in x. If this happens, if these two conditions happen, then it must be that the following two conditions happen. So, T4 dot y must be equal to T2 dot y, and T4 dot this r minus y minus x, so all the attribute values for r minus y minus x for T4 should be equal to that for T1. So this is a formal definition of this. So if these two conditions happen, when this is the case, then these two must occur. So this is the definition of the multi-value dependency. X multi-value, so depends, multi-value determines y. Now an example will be the better way of understanding it. So here is what I am trying to do. So suppose this is x, this is y, and this is all the attributes that are not in x and y. So this is essentially r minus y minus x. And let us now consider first tuple T1, which has value a, and this is b, this is c, this is the values. Now the T2 also has the same x value, which is a, and it has got different y and r minus y. So let us say those are d and e. Now if T3 has e and T4 has a, then it must happen that this combination BC and DE must again take place. So it's essentially BE and DC. They must be happening. So because this is the combination and this is the combination, both these combinations must be there in the relation, and then it is called that X multi-value determines Y. Now from the symmetry of this, one can say that if X multi-value determines Y, so if there is an MVD X goes to Y, then there is also the MVD that X multi-value determines to R minus Y minus X, and that is obvious from the example and the definition of this. And in the database course that we saw, the example of the database course that we saw earlier, essentially what is happening is that the course MVD to from course to teacher exists when the relation is this course, teacher and book. Now what does that mean is that suppose there is the course is this database. So that means that if there is a course database, which is the course, and if there is a teacher, let us say AB, and if that teacher teaches a book FDB, if this happens, and if there is another tuple for the same course database, and then there is some other person XY which teaches some other book DBA book, if these two tuples happen, so if the teacher AB teaches the book FDB and if the teacher XY teaches the book DBM, then it must happen that in that relation the two other tuples must also exist. So, AB must be able to teach with the book DBM and XY must be able to teach with the book FDB. Now, if this, why is this required? Intuitively, if this does not happen, then there is something special about the book and the teacher. It is not about the course. Then the teacher probably prefers that book more, much more, and refuses to use the other books, and similar things may happen. So, that is not a desirable situation, and this is why this multi-valued dependency is useful. Alright. So, now if we use this, then we can move ahead and see how multi-valued dependency is actually useful for a lossless join. We define this concept of a lossless join, and here is the thing. So, suppose there is this relation R with X, Y and Z, and then if X MVD Y, then also X MVD Z determines. Now, if this relation is now broken up into the following manner, that this is XY, so R1 is equal to your XY and R2 is equal to XZ, let us say. Now, and then we take the join of R1, natural join of R1 with R2, which is of course on X. This must give us back the relation R. So, that is the whole point. So, essentially we can say, write it in a different manner, that R is equal to your, so if you project it only on X and Y, then this is simply equal to, if you project it on X and Z on R. So, that is the same as saying R1 must, so this must hold. Then this satisfies your MVD, and then if this MVD, if this lossless joint condition holds, this, because this MVD is hold, then an R can be broken down into XY and XZ, which is a much better design as we saw, because we do not need to store all the tuples of this teacher and course. We just need to store that DB is, can be taught by this teacher and DB can use this book, and that is good. So, this is essentially the why MVD is useful, because it defines this concept of lossless joint. And now, similar to all the other things, is this MVD can be used to define certain things. So, before that, just simple things is that X MVD Y is called trivial if the following things happen: either Y is part of X, or simply R is equal to X union Y. So, I mean, this is an OR condition. This either this or this happens, then this is called a trivial, and any other MVD is non-trivial. Okay, fine. So, then analogously, like the functional dependencies, the closure of a set of MVDs can be defined, etc. And then there are different inference rules for MVDs, such as complementation, augmentation, transitive, replication and coalescence. But using that, let us define what is called the fourth normal form. So, this is the fourth normal form, or the 4NF, and 4NF essentially, a relation is said to be in 4NF if there is a functional dependency, if X this is non-trivial, if this is non-trivial, then X is a super key. So, for every non-trivial thing, the left side is a super key. Now, there is an alternative definition, just as we saw the definitions for other things, there is an alternative definition, and the alternative definition says that for every MVD, X to Y, the two conditions happen: either it is trivial or X is a super key. It is the same definition, and this is what the definition of the fourth normal form is. So, that is how to define the fourth normal form, and the example we have already seen, just to recap it. So, this course teacher book and the primary key is all of these together is the primary key, and this if the MVD course to book exists there, if course to book exists, then this relation can be broken down into this course teacher and course book. Now, what happens in this case is, so if this is the only MVD that is there, the first thing we need to test is whether this is 4NF or not. The question is whether this is in 4NF or not. Now, the thing is, course is not a super key. So, this relation is not in 4NF. So, that is the problem with this. And therefore, once we do the 4NF normalization, suppose we do this what is called the 4NF normalization, then the following things happen is that this is broken down into the following two relations, which is course with book and course with teacher, and the only functional the MVDs are from course to book and from course to teacher, so which are both trivial because x goes to y and the right side and the r minus y minus x is empty. So, these are trivial. So, this is by definition in 4NF. So, this is a better design than using this entire thing because as we argued earlier, this has got modification anomalies in the sense that if a new book is introduced, multiple updates require, and or if a new teacher is introduced, multiple updates are required in this relation, but not in these two. So, these two are in a better design. That is the whole point of the MVD and the fourth 4NF, the fourth normal form. Now, the MVD can be extended to a general concept which is called the join dependency or JD. This is essentially, as I have been saying, that from MVD onwards it goes into the realm of more theoretical than practical things, and JD is an even more higher form of theoretical dependency. It essentially says that if there is a relation R for a, so suppose the relation R consists of this, it can be broken up into these things R1 to Rn, then if you take the any Ri from this relation R, R belongs to this R, the R is a relation instance for the relation schema capital R, and if you join all of them together, then you get what is known the original relation R. This is of course from I equal to all the n. So, if this condition holds, then there seems to be join dependency. So, essentially the idea of join dependency is the following. In MVD what we did is that we broke up the relation R into two parts, R1 and R2, such that the join of R1 and R2, the natural join of course, gives back the relation, the complete relation R. Now, here what we are doing is that we are breaking up the schema capital R into different sets of attributes R1 to Rn, such that the join of all of these together gives back the actual original relation. So, that is when it happens for any, for all possible instances or all legal instances of the relation. Small r. So, then this is called the join dependency, and one can see that multi-value dependency can be now defined as a special case of join dependency. So, MVD is a special case of join dependency where the n equal to 2, that is it essentially. So, it is just broken up into two parts, and if you break it up into multiple parts, then it is called join dependency. Now, just as we could define a fourth normal form using the multi-value dependency, we can define what is known as the fifth normal form using this join dependency. This is called the fifth normal form or 5NF. In a similar manner, the fifth normal form is also sometimes called project join normal form because essentially it says that once you join, once you project it out on this particular attributes and join it, you get back the original relation. So, that is called a project join normal form or PJNF. So, again these are mostly theoretical things, and example can be the following. So, suppose there is a brand and a product and a salesman, then it can be probably broken up into two parts at a time. So it can be, these can be taken or these can be taken or these along with these can be taken, and an example can be found out. And a very quick example may be the following. So here in this example, if this brand, product, salesman has been broken up into these three relations, brand, product, salesman, brand, and product, salesman, then one can see that the natural join of all of these three labels together gives back the original relation, brand, product, salesman, such that the join dependency is satisfied. So this is a much better design than keeping this original design of brand, product, salesman, because for example, the insertion, the modification anomalies are minimal here, because now insertion of a particular salesman promotes a particular brand, that can be done by using inserting in only one case. For example, if J salesman does it in brand A, it just needs to be inserted here instead of multiple insertions in the original table where it contains all the three attributes. So that is the project join normal form. The final form of this is called the domain key normal form, or the DKNF. This is considered the highest form of normalization, and this is essentially just a theoretical concept. And here it says that a relation schema is said to be in DKNF if all the constraints and relations that should hold can be enforced simply by the domain's constraint and the key constraint. So everything that should hold can be enforced by simply the domain constraints and the key constraints, that's it. So we do not require any other constraints or any other conditions, etc. So these two essentially define everything that this relation should hold, that's all. So this is the ideal normal form, and this is mostly theoretical, and everything after 3NF or BCNF is mostly theoretical, and database practitioners do not attempt to do it. So this is in, that's it. And so once a relation is in DKNF, because this is ideal, there is no anomaly, there is absolutely no anomaly, and all the functional dependencies and multi-value dependencies need not be checked anymore. So this is the ideal case, and that ends the topic on normalization. So essentially, given a relation, one would try to normalize it up to 3NF or BCNF. Thank you.